if you ask me, I would say that this is scientific. You can't conjecture. And therefore, I am aware that the police have the best DNA lab in the whole of the sub-region.
Yeah.
They have the best DNA lab in the whole of the sub-region.
Maybe including Nigeria?
Yes.
Sure.
We have the best. Sure.
What makes us, ours the best?
I mean, it's the top on the range.
Mm-hmm.
Top on the range. That's what it means, top on the range. And so it means that you can only go, if you want to do this outside West Africa, you might have to go to, we used to do this in South Africa.
Yeah.
So it means you have to go to South Africa, or you have to go to the north, maybe Egypt, or maybe Morocco, or any Tunisia. But apart from that, in West Africa, you won't find the kind of equipment the Ghana police has in terms of DNA testing and, you know, this type of forensic analysis.
And expertise
expertise. And so as far as I'm concerned, probably the too much of your conjecturing, we need to stop and, you know, subject this to proper scientific proof so that we don't
police
have...
Police say they've done it already.
Yes, yeah, so, but you have...
Just like Dr. Afaka, you're saying that it's important at this stage.
Yes.
To get the family to do their own.
They should do their own or else that permanent, you know, state of denial.
Mm.
If it is not done, that permanent state of denial, because then you have too many people speaking to a subject that sometimes, for their own parochial interest, they try to spin it around and try to confuse everybody and don't go to get the report, try to speak to even those who took part in this whole analysis. Because then I am, if for instance, if I want to question Dr. Afuakwe's credibility in terms of if he was part of the team who did this analysis, the only way I can do that is not to sit out there and just question. I would want the reports of what he did. Did he follow the protocols? Because then if you want to mix water with sugar, you mix water with sugar. If you go to mix water with oil, you would get a different results. But if he followed the process, then you would say, oh, being probably a forensic analyst, looking at this, I think Dr. Afuakwe missed some of the protocols. But it looks like the talking is too much. So I would ask that the parents, the police should assist them with all the resources. And it is expensive. There's one thing we shouldn't lose sight, even though we can't equate that to how the family feels. It is expensive. And though I'm just looking at it and saying that for purposes of bringing proper closure to this, the state, I wouldn't even say the police, the state should assist them. If it's no matter how much it's going to cost, the state should assist them to subject this to another test. Because then I've heard, comments such as when they were doing, the police were doing the analysis, they didn't bring the family in. You know, I believe that in criminal, investigations, they found something that is suspected to be human remains. At that point, the police themselves couldn't have even said it is human remains. You have to find out if it is human remains, then you move on. Whose human remain is this? Remains are these. And so if you brought the family members into, let's say, this is the lab, and it ends up that these human remains are not that of your family, have you not violated these other human remains you have found? And so mine is that police needed to do, the law mandates them to do what they have done. They have brought their portion of the case in terms of matching, the human remains to some their relation. They've done that. And so that case, for the police, if you ask me, I would say it's closed. The families can move further to say, we want to do our own independent.
You said the state should assess that process.
Yes, the state should assess.